Hello everyone, the other day I was organizing my bookshelf and I found this. This is a book I put together around 6 years ago, and it's a compilation of all the bizarre foods I ate in that year because I was really into trying bizarre foods at that time, and I actually still am right now. Some of you may not know that though, because I haven't tried a ton of bizarre foods on this channel, but I have tried these bugs that you can see in the front. The whole reason I was inspired to make this book is because I saw the show called Bizarre Foods, and it's on Travel Channel. I really recommend that you guys go look it up because I really enjoy it. It's a lot of fun. It's basically where this dude, Andrew Zimmern, he just goes around the US and around the world trying bizarre foods. So let's go ahead and take a look at our book here. So this is one of the first foods I tried. It's Chopalinas. It actually was featured in the episode of Bizarre Foods. And basically, Chopalinas are just fried grasshoppers, and they're served with tortilla chips. I was personally not a big fan of these, because I have had grasshoppers after that. I don't think I show it in this book, but I have had them in the past after trying it for the first time, and I did enjoy it after that. But I didn't enjoy it in this preparation because I thought that they put too much lime on it, and they were kind of bitter too, so it wasn't my most favorite bizarre food to try, although it wasn't the worst. All right, here is star fruit. This isn't a super crazy food, it's just an interesting, more exotic fruit. It kind of reminds me of a mild apple, and I actually found some at Whole Foods a couple of months ago, and I was really excited about it because they are kind of hard to find. You can usually find them at the Asian supermarket, kind of like at Ranch 99, and I really enjoy it. It kind of tastes like a mild apple. Here is some of the more cringe-worthy and crazy bizarre foods I've had. So you can see right here, I tried tendon, and I did enjoy that. It's kind of just like fatty meat. It didn't really taste super crazy, but the other ones are kind of crazy. Tripe and pizzle. So let's start with the less weird one. Tripe is basically the inner cow intestine. I thought it didn't really have much of a flavor. It's just kind of like chewing on rubber bands. And I was like, it just tastes like tough meat that has no flavor. Almost just like chewing on a rubber eraser. So it wasn't really that pleasant. And you think, oh, it's in soup. Maybe it has some of the soup flavor. No, not really. It's just pretty bland. And now here's for the really cringe-worthy one. Some of you may be wondering, what the heck is pizzle? Oh wait, is that the thing I give my dog? Because my dog really enjoys bully sticks, which they sometimes call pizzle. But basically, pizzle is just ox penis, so that might be kind of disturbing for some of you, but they're a big fan of it in Vietnam because I got in Vietnamese noodle soup, also known as pho, but I wasn't really a big fan of it. It wasn't so much the idea or the flavor, it was more of the texture. As you could imagine, it kind of has a very cringy and unpleasant texture. It almost reminds me of like the texture of Vaseline. Almost like you left some Vaseline out in the sun and let it dry up a little bit and take a solid form. It's just really gooey and it just kind of coats your mouth and it has no flavor. So very unpleasant for me. Next thing I tried, chicken hearts. I had these in New York City. And as you know, this is not the trip that I went to New York City like a year ago or so. This was obviously in 2014, but it's chicken hearts, grilled chicken hearts. And I actually really enjoy them still to this day. They're very juicy and they're full of yummy juice. And honestly, it just tastes like a juicy cut of chicken. If you don't really think about it too much, it actually tastes amazing. Just tastes like meat, honestly. And these are a couple of the dishes from one of my best meals I've ever had. This was at Sogale in Oak Park, California. Really sad, but they are unfortunately closed now. They closed probably a couple of years ago, actually, after I went here. But this is the pork pate I had there. It was some of the best pate I have had. And yes, I've gone to Paris before. And it was amazing. It was very smooth, creamy, and it wasn't super gamey. And this is frog's legs. These were so delicious. They were pan-fried with some garlic and tomatoes, and they were so juicy. Honestly reminded me of almost like a chicken drumstick. But as you know, frog has a slightly different taste. Almost reminded me of like a mix between like white fish and chicken. And it was very juicy and delicious. It's so super flavorful from all the sauce. And that's this trying food with my Aunt Jane. And we both really enjoyed that restaurant when they were open. Unfortunately, I only was able to go there once before they closed, but you know, that's the tough life of restaurant business. Here is beef tongue. So this is probably one of the less weird foods I've tried in this book. Some of you may have even had it yourselves, but beef tongue, honestly, it's just a little bit like a tougher cut of beef, but I kind of like the texture to it because it's usually sliced very thin, and it usually has some fatty flavor to it, and especially when it's grilled like this on a grill, it's very delicious. And I actually did a video here. This was at, you know what? I can't really remember the name of it, but the title of my video was called Cooking with Fire, so you can go ahead and check that video out if you're interested. But it was at a Japanese barbecue restaurant. Ah, the name just came back. Yukaku. It's called Yukaku, and it's a Japanese barbecue restaurant. Anyways, moving on. So right here, as you can see, I was at dim sum, and I tried chicken feet and jellyfish, both of which are some of my favorite bizarre foods. And actually, I just kind of tried it for this video. Or, not for this video, but for this book, because I was trying to put together this book, because I had had it before then. Specifically here, I thought their chicken feet were a little bit greasy for my liking, but they're still delicious. And, of course, the jellyfish was amazing. I actually tried jellyfish and chicken feet in a previous video where I had them some. It was earlier this January, so you could check that out if you're interested in it. It was called the cutest dim sum in the Bay Area. Anyways, but this is olive vera. See, I just saw this at the market, and I was like, whoa, that looks crazy cool. I'm just gonna see if I can eat it. And I did some research, found out, alright, it's olive vera, it's a cactus. People eat it a lot of times for health benefits. I was like, why not add another picture to my Bizarre Foods book and have some health benefits in the process? But I realized, you know, sometimes super healthy things that are full of tons of vitamins aren't the best tasting. Although, I learned later that it can be put into a drink, but it was just kind of bitter. The texture was okay, it was kind of crunchy, slightly slimy, but not unreasonably so. But it was kind of very, very bitter, and it just wasn't very pleasant. I think it maybe needs to be added with like a sweeter beverage or something. But right here is one of my most favorite fruits in the world. It is rambutan. So it looks kind of crazy on the outside. It definitely looks like a bizarre food. It's all hairy and stuff. It's kind of hard to tell in the photo because it is kind of small. And the inside is kind of clearish and whitish, almost opaque. And it's very chewy. It's kind of interesting. It almost has a slight chew, almost like a gummy bear. But then it's kind of crunchy at the same time. So the texture is very exciting and amazing. And the flavor is super tropical. Almost, you know, it almost has like a tropical sort of grape flavor. Almost tastes like the tropics with some grape. But almost reminds me of Concord grape. It's kind of a unique flavor. It's kind of hard to explain. But right here you can see is jackfruit. See, I got this at the Chinese market. I got it specifically at Ranch 99. And it's basically this huge giant fruit. And it grows on these super tall trees. And it grows in the tropics. I think it grows in Indonesia, if I remember correct. That's one of the countries it grows in. But they're really dangerous, because as you could see, if it falls on you, you're dead. Like, this is definitely gonna kill you if it falls on you. But I got it at the market, and I was like, ooh, this looks super cool. Looks like this super giant fruit, super spiky, super intimidating. I wanna take it down and eat it. But, turns out, you can see, it looks alright, but the flavor, I don't know what it was. It was just kind of starchy. Maybe it wasn't the ripest. It was kind of sour. And it had sticky sap everywhere when you cut it. It was just not one of my most favorite exotic fruits I've ever had. See, this is mangosteen, and I'm really thankful to my friends, the No family, for introducing me to it. It's a very tropical fruit. And it almost looks like bulbs of garlic, as you can see. And it's very juicy and sweet and very soft and delicate. And it kind of just melts in your mouth. Again, it's very tropical tasting, but kind of has a unique flavor that's not really able to be put into words. Almost reminds me of like maybe like an apple and a banana combined. My brain does get a little foggy though, because I haven't had it in years, because it's just really hard to find. Although I do enjoy it. See, this is dragon fruit, this wonderful pink fruit, you see. Some of you might have had it. I wouldn't say it's the most bizarre fruit, but I think it does have some interesting characteristics. It's sort of crunchy and soft at the same time, and it has some seeds in it, almost like a strawberry. But I thought that dragon fruit, for the most part, I've tried it multiple times. All the times I've had it, it's been pretty bland and kind of mild, but I'm sure if you get a really good and fresh dragon fruit, it'll be more delicious. But personally, I wasn't a big fan of it when I tried it. Here is durian. See, this is one of the more crazy foods I've had in terms of wow factor. It's very stinky. It's almost like rotten onions. See, this one was frozen. I feel like the frozen, because it was frozen, it kind of took out some of the stink, because it kind of smells like rotten onions and dirty gym stocks and basically a whole bunch of other bad things you could think of. But when I tried it, it was actually kind of mild, almost like vanilla custard. Had a hint of maybe like some raw onion flavor, but it wasn't really super strong, so I could handle it. And it was kind of pleasant because the texture was very soft and custardy. I actually tried it a while back on my channel, maybe like 2 years ago if I remember correctly. And it wasn't so good then because it was a lot stronger. And that's just me trying the durian. I wasn't so sure, it was kind of smelled. But it ended up being alright at the end. This is balut. This is all from the No family, so big shout out and thanks to them for introducing me to all these crazy foods. But this is balut. It's a duck embryo that's in the egg and it's still developing. And I actually tried this on my channel, probably I think in February if my mind serves me correctly. And I really enjoy it. Is I knew after I had it this first time I had to get it again. Because basically it's a duck fetus inside egg, and when you open it up, there's this delicious liquid in it, and it almost reminds me of like chicken soup, and it's just amazing. It's definitely something you have to try if you're not super squeamish. And these are dong bagito. These are bugs, as you can see. You know, the spicy mealworms, the chili lime crickets, and the chocolate covered superworms. And these are from Dong Bagito in San Francisco. They're just a small family-owned business. They're actually featured on an episode of Bizarre Foods. And I really enjoy their bugs. I actually tried them maybe a little over a year ago, maybe a year and a half ago on this channel. And I really enjoyed them. So they're just kind of mild. These were the mealworms. They almost remind me of almost like popcorn that hasn't been fully cooked. Although they're very crispy. So maybe I take that back. It's almost like a corn chip. So that's actually, and you might think, oh, did it, are they full of icky guts? No, because they're slow roasted, so they're all dried out. They're super crispy, and they're mildly spicy, and I really love them. These are the chili lime crickets. I think they're more tart than spicy. I think they're kind of sour, but I like it because I'm a big fan of lime. So it's kind of limey, little bit spicy, and very crunchy. These also sort of remind me of corn chips, although they do have a slightly different flavor. They're, I don't know how to describe it. They're just very mild, almost like mild popcorn in my opinion. And I think it's very good. I definitely recommend heading to the Ferry Building once this whole outbreak thing is over and heading to Dong Bagito, because I really enjoy that. Because they're just a little stand that's at the Ferry Building in San Francisco. And they're pretty cool. I've definitely gone there a ton of times, including one of the times for this book, because I really enjoy their bugs. Crazy, right? But here I try venison and buffalo. See, it's kind of hard to tell which is which, but I think this one might be venison, that one might be buffalo. Buffalo, you know, wasn't super crazy, it just tasted like a steak. Venison kind of tasted like a game meat. It tasted pretty gamey, almost like a really gamey steak, but I actually didn't think it was too bad. I thought it was just alright. And yeah, that's the end of this book. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know if you liked it by hitting the like button. And yeah, that'll be it for today. I'll make sure to put the Bizarre Foods playlist at the end of this video, and that'll be it. Bye-bye, everyone.